up, Menos? Your boy Shocker360 from Menos.com. Here we go, playing again the perfect offense. We talked about the perfect defense on our last video, and I'm going to show you how to run the perfect offense. On perfect offense, you have to, this is a super custom. For online rank, I recommend super custom. I don't recommend anything else, unless you have a really awesome scheme. But super custom is really the thing to use online, even on online tournaments. That super customs are allowed because you have a lot of options. You could go run down the middle, have the best runs to the outside. That's what I like to do. I have all the best runs to the outside, all the best runs to the middle, all the best counters, all the best inside zones that are really hard to defense, and I use them in every situation. For in this case, we're coming out of full house. This time we come out. Look at how I read the defense. Look at how spread the defense is in the middle. So it's a really perfect time to use the inside zone. So you got to make sure you make those reads. A lot of people have a hard time stopping the run, so if they can't stop a simple counter to the outside, or they start adjusting to the outside, you could definitely just audible down to an inside zone. Or as you guys can see here, a strong power. We're going to make a read. We got more people on the right side, and so I like to flip it. I like to flip my players a lot. I like to flip my players. I like to motion the slot. I like to motion the outside wide receiver. We come out in a counter, and he got us good right here. I kind of had a feeling he was going to stop us there because in the way his linebackers were positioned, they're positioned in the middle. So in that situation, if you try to run to the middle, the linebackers are going to get in there and stop the run. So you want to try to mix it up. I have situational plays for in case we got the 0-1 trap. We don't use it all the time. Now, we could abuse a 0-1 trap, but I'd rather just use it in situations like this, like 3rd and 4th, 2nd and 6, 1st and 5, or whatever, stuff like that. I like to use them in situational place, like in the situation where I really need it, because sometimes a lot of you guys tend to abuse certain plays instead of having different set of plays where you could just run a counter or a strong power, and then all of a sudden you need those extra yards, and you know you have that money play that's really awesome, or you got the best run in the game, and you all of a sudden use that play and you're gonna get those extra yards you need. Like for example, right here, we coming out on the deep out. I believe we barely got this first down here. So we're happy to get that first down and first and goal. We coming out of a turnover, so that's good. That means that we, if we score here, even if we score a field goal, we get the advantage. So we're already in the first. We're already in the field goal range. And it's not even our turn. It's his turn to score, but we stopped him. So if we get a field goal, we're going to be on top no matter what, because we still receive the second half. So you got to be thinking about all the situations you're in. In this case right here, the counter is not working. I thought maybe I was going to get a little bit of yards. So maybe Hunter's not going to do the job there. So I'm going to go ahead and think about Hyde and Gore moving them there. Look at how he has his linebackers to the inside, almost facing the tight end. Now he moves them to the outside. We're going to motion this wide receiver right there to the inside, and we get the extra blocking we need to get. At least get a couple, 4 to 5 yards at least. So as you guys saw there, we ran the counter, and we got the yards that we needed. Now it's time to use a situational play. I'm not passed the whole game. This is the only time I'm going to pass right here to get it right in between the zones. We threw it right before he got there, and that was perfect. And now we're going to go ahead and go into our next series. And as you guys can see here, we stopped him on defense. So we're going to go ahead and motion the outside wide receiver, and we get the extra blocking. We're always going to motion different players or flip the play that I like to use. And you're going to notice what I'm talking about when I flip the play or I actually motion a different player. In that case, we motion the outside. You see, we coming out on the play flipped, and then we flip it again. I always like to do that. For some reason, I feel like it does give me better blocking. Look how many people are on the right, though. Look at the reads. This guy has everybody overloaded to the right. Gore right here did not have enough acceleration. If you had, like, let's say Jamal Charles there, he would have definitely been gone, or a faster running back, or DeMarco Murray. He would have been gone. But in this case, we're coming out on the full house counter. Nope. He's having everybody. He's setting everybody to the outside, setting up everybody to the outside to contain the edge right there. So I gotta come out in something different. In this case, it's 3rd and 10. We're already there. We're already in the field goal. He has not scored. We already stopped him twice. So it's our turn to score now. Right here, we score now, or we don't score. We're all right. We're not gonna have to rush it. We don't have to do anything. We got control of this game. That's what we want on offense. We want to have control of the game at all times. It's 4th and 4. We decided to go for it, but we could, again, go in the inside zone and try to get those 4 yards. But I don't feel too confident right now since they already stopped us twice. He's trying to block my field goal, so you got to be ready for those things, like the field goal blocks, especially at the top 100 level. This guy is a top 100 player. So again, you gotta be careful with those in that situation. If he would have blocked it once, I would have never kicked another field goal again in this game. So here we go. We get that counter to the right this time. We flip the play, and then we had the counter going to the right. He probably expected to go to the left, and this time we got him good. So now we're gonna attack the right, no matter what. So you guys can see here, we're gonna go call a counter again. So we're kind of, the reason we're calling the counter again is because I want to waste a little bit of clock, keep the clock running, and I want to go ahead and you guys gonna go ahead and just keep attacking since it was first down. We are second and nine. We do the counter to the left. It's not gonna work because we actually already ran it a couple of times, so the defense is gonna pick up on that. So let's go ahead and come out in something that we haven't used yet or that much in this game, so we can go ahead and keep moving the yard. So the yardstick. So here we go, coming out in split close, as you guys can see here, and we're gonna go ahead and like to block the running back. Sometimes I like to go ahead and slant in X, as you guys can see here, streak circle. We have blockers there, so we're good on the blocking. He's not blitzing anybody. We almost throw a pick. That was stupid. Could have waited down the middle. It could have been a pick down the middle. But since we're up by 10 points, I'm going to go ahead and go for it anyway. So we're going to come out in strong close. I have not used this play at all. I like strong close because you got that route with the outside wide receiver going to the inside. And there we go. Circle going to the inside. I don't see anything open there. We manually move Gore right there. We playmaker him to get those extra yards. And then we throw it to him, and we get a first down. So that was really smart. That was actually my last read. My first read was circle. Then I just threw it to, dumped it to the running back, and we got him there. So we got 20 seconds left. Situational plays. Like I said, you got to be in a situation. You got to know what to run. In this situation right here, we're coming out in the trips tight end. This is one of my deep passes play. I could throw deep anytime. Notice that he has everybody down. The safety's down. I don't think he has any safeties. Everybody's manned up. We're going to go ahead and send this guy to block in. There we go. We got square. We motion him to the top. Wide open. We playmaker him there. And we're at the 1 yard line with 10 seconds left to go. So that was a really good. Guys, don't just run the play stock. In this case, guys, I had to playmaker. You have to learn how to playmaker. You want to play at this level, guys. Some of you guys think that just because it's there, you just run everything stock and you don't have to make any reads on the defense. You just run the play as is. And sometimes you guys think that you don't have to playmaker. In that case, you need to learn to playmaker to get players open sometimes. They're not going to be open all the time. That's the thing. They're not going to be open all the time. So you got to playmaker. You got to make reads on defense. You got to read the defense. Same thing on offense. You got to read the offense. What are they doing? What are the formations? What routes can beat you on defense? Except look at how he's bringing the safety down. All right, that's also his run support is gone. Basically, if I beat the second level, I'm gone. I don't have to worry about three levels. So right there, look at this. That was the last guy to beat there. We would have gone past him. We would have definitely gone to the house. So we're here in the third quarter. We're doing really good. We're going to go ahead and flip the play run once again. As you guys can see here, I think we audible to a 0-1 trap. Yes, we got it. Look at this. He's moving everybody down, so he has no safety over the top, and we're going to go ahead and just run it up the gut, as you guys can see here. 17-0 in this game, playing a guy that's ranked 73 overall. He probably ranked like 65 right now, but we're trying to get that ranking up. And here we go. We're running to the outside. Since he has everybody down the line, we have great blocking, and we're getting those extra yards, as you guys can see here. Situational plays. I had not used that play the whole game until right now. All right, I wanted to surprise him with that. Let's see how, if he knew how to stop it, since he's bringing everybody down. And now we're going back to the base play, which is a counter, and we're gonna go ahead and run it to the outside, just make moves. He has no answer to this. Annoying as hell. He's annoyed right now. He's probably just wondering what the hell did I get into, or he probably thought that he had a chance against me. So here we go, running that counter again. He can't stop it. We get the great blocking. We run it in for a touchdown. Opponent decides to go ahead and send me a concede defeat. And this is how you run the perfect offense, guys, on PS4. You guys want to play the top 100 level, this is how you do it, guys. My opponent decided to concede defeat. And at the same time, guys, like I told you, my opponent, it was a top 100 player, Myrtleville 30. You can see him there, the top 100. He's ranked around 71 now that I beat him with a losing streak of 2 games. So we got him here, guys. Like I said, this is legit. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe if you guys want more videos like this to help you guys win more games. Or go check out the Madden All-Star Guides at MaddenAllStars.com. Bye.